Good morning to one and all. Today our concept is multi-user and multi-account interaction. What we want to learn about the multi-user and multi-account interaction? The name, what does it says exactly? Multi-user, in the sense more than one user and more than one account, how we can interact. Okay. In this concept, we can study about more than one user and more than one account, how they will interact. Okay, an application featuring multi-user single screen interaction requires special support in the application platform, such as handling the events from multiple and similar input devices independently from each other. What I meant to say in the sense, multi-user and multi-account interaction, what does the aim in the sense? Now coming to this application, the act of, what the act of putting to a special use or whatever it may be, some purpose, ma'am. And an application featuring suggest an outstanding that attracts attention more than one user. It uses a single screen interaction, it requires so the special support in that application platform. Application platform is nothing but an application platform as a service. It refers to a cloud environment. What is a cloud? Cloud is a widely distributed network. It to support something data. It supports a huge amount of data. It stores by using with the help of cloud to store an huge amount of data at a cloud via remote servers. Okay, it's nothing but the concept of cloud environment. It can refer an application platform as a service. For we want to designing and we want to building and we want to deploying or delivering, and we want to managing the custom the business applications. Okay, an application featuring, in the sense the act of putting to a special use or purpose, the feature suggests you an outstanding that attracts attention more than one user, single screen interaction. So it requires a special support in the application platform. How we can design, how we want to build, and how we want to deploying and to managing the custom business applications. In simple terms, we want to say it's a single platform. What platform, ma'am? It's a single platform that enables to speed and collaboration, and we want to control across the entire application life cycle. So now in that application platform, such as we want to handling some events like actions from multiple users, and we want to say some similar, in the sense same input devices independently from each other. What exactly I want to say in the sense, by using this concept we have to learn about, in addition, if multiple remote users should be able to work in the same way as local server, local users, and if user interface actions should be linked to that users, and an adequate concept representing the users and their actions is needed. So what is nothing but user interface is nothing but at the most basic level, the user interface is the series of screens, ma'am, and pages, and we can see some visual elements like buttons and icons that enables a person to interact with some product, or we can say a service. Okay, what I meant to say in the sense, using hands to represent user input morphics. What is a morphic in the sense? We cannot comparable or pertaining to shape. Okay, morphic is nothing but we don't want to comparable or rare. It is a completely object-oriented graphical user interface framework. Okay, first we want to implement it for the self-programming languages
It was later adopted by a Squeak Small Talk. Squeak in the sense, a polite, what I mean to say in the sense, a high-pitched sound. In the sense, to make a high-pitched sound, it's a small talk, like a polite conversation about some unimportant matters, especially as engaged in an social occasions. Okay. So, in applications implemented with morphic, it's not comparable. Every visual element on the screen, it is represented by an object in the code. So, even the mouse pointer, these objects used by morphic are called, one more name we can say, morphs. So, according to this, the object representing the mouse pointer is called hand morph. Okay, hand morph. Mouse pointer is also known as, we can say, hand morph. So, so the concept here, what we can say here, so the concept of hands allows having multiple hands, more than one hands, that can be controlled by different sources. So, every hand object is responsible for communication with the respective input source, and we want to say some generates a corresponding user interface, a framework, events such as like nothing but actions. So the default hand communicates with the operating system and processes by default streams, in the sense some data flow of mouse and keyboard events. So what I mean to say, hand object are also able to determine the user interface elements, nothing but what we want to say like morphs, not comparable, that is currently focused on keyboard events. So that is directly below the mouse, a pointer, ma. With that knowledge, they triggers, what the trigger, a triggers, is trigger is something but a small device, ma, that releases a spring, or we can say catch, and so sets of a mechanism, especially in order to fire a gun. It's nothing but a trigger, it is nothing but a small a device. A trigger is nothing but what I meant to say, really, in the sense that is directly below the mouse pointer. With that knowledge, they trigger the corresponding applications, even we can processing for each incoming event. Later we can see, by using this concept, additional, what we can see, additional input streams, additional input streams, it can be integrated. So multiple hands, that is like mouse pointers and cursors, it can be controlled by different input sources. So current operating system, however, support only one system, cursor, and we can say the input events from different devices are merged into a one input event stream. Is nothing, ma. First of all, we in your desktop, so if you have to install realvnc.com download, VNC in the sense virtual network computing. Okay, later in your mobile phone also, if you have to go to the Play Store and then install VNC app, in the sense virtual network computing app, in the sense by using some remote servers, we have to sharing the software. What you have to done at the mobile phone, that will be displayed onto the your desktops, in the sense, or a PCs, whatever, if you have to do like a keyboard, if you have to touch a V letter, in the same way, similar way that the desktop screen also touches the V, like we can, we if you want to install some virtual network computing software, if you have to controlling hands via multiple input devices, more than one input devices, or virtual network computing. Okay, this is nothing but the concept of more than one users can handle more than one account interaction by using this virtual network computing. Okay. what you have to done at your mobile phones. First of all, what I meant to say, listen carefully, otherwise we can't able to understand this concept. First of all, if you have to take your mobile phone, if you want to take your mobile phone, at that your mobile phone, if you move to the Play Store app, at the Play Store app, if you have to download VNC download VNC app, in the sense virtual network computing app, as well as a similar way, if you go to the your laptops or your mobile or your PCs or your desktops, as well as your Vishma tabs also, in that also, if you have to go to the Google Chrome, if you have to download a real virtual network computing dot com download VNC app, if you have to download at your PC or a desktop or a tab or desktops, as if you have to download this app at your mobiles as well as at your PCs, whatever if you have to done at your mobile phone, first of all, for example, if you have to touch the keypad at your mouse pointer, for example, if you have to touch the keypad design thinking DESI something numbers will be there in your keypad, something alphabets is there, 104 key letters will be there at your keypad, at your mobile or at your laptop. Can you first, if you have to enter design thinking at your mobile phone, at the same way in at your laptops also, whatever if you have to touch at your mobile phone design thinking the letters, that the same thing will link to the your PC. Okay, this is the concept of virtual network computing. How we want to compute, how we want to calculate the network through a virtually the input devices, as well as you have, if you have to control your hands, more than one user and multi account interaction, it will be done through the concept of virtual network computing. What exactly I meant to say, in the sense, when multiple users interact with a single screen, okay, so it is usually desired that they can work with the application independently. So this is comparable to a physical whiteboard where multiple users can draw at the same time. This requirement can be achieved by using the concept of hands. Whatever if you have to do at your mobile phone, as well as the same thing will be run at your PCs. The concept of hands by using, it can be achieved by using this requirement. So hand objects obtain their action, their event data from the corresponding input stream autonomously. Okay, what I meant to say, in the sense, by using this concept, additional input streams can be integrated. So multiple hands, that is mouse pointers and cursors, can be controlled by a different input source. Later we can take some common operating systems. It can activate multiple input devices, but support only one system, a cursor. Input events from these different devices are merged into one input event stream. So thus it makes no difference whether the connected mouse or the built-in touchpad. It is used to control the system, a cursor, okay, to bypass the operation system's behavior. We want to develop a special support for SWIG's virtual machine. Okay, so the virtual machine plugins access separate streams of input event data. By using this special lower level operating system, application programming interfaces, we want to approach the design of our virtual machine extensions. And now we can allow the attaching and detaching input devices during the application runtime. So the screen sharing or terminal server technologies, such as virtual network computing, or we can say one more name, remote desktop protocol, it also support only one cursor per session, overall participants. So the applications and underlying the protocols except only the input stream of one user, we can use it. This is the concept of we can controlling hands via multiple input devices or virtual network computing. Now we can see one more, that is nothing but impersonating hands. In the sense, impersonating hands, in the sense, to assume the character or appearance, to mimic that voice also, to act is nothing but to act or play the part of what we want to do to represent impersonally. Okay, this is nothing but impersonating hands. What exactly we can say a virtual network computing, in the sense, in small talk we can say sweet small talk, it must be a polite conversation about unimportant matters, especially we want to engage in an social occasions, ma. Okay, what I meant to say in the sense, the concept of multi-user multi-account interaction, the concept is related to the virtual network computing. What exactly a virtual network computing is nothing but in computing, virtual network computing is a graphical desktop sharing system. What I meant to say now, it is a graphical desktop sharing a system that uses the remote frame buffer. What they use, remote frame buffer, it is a temporary storage area. We want to frame some remote users protocol, so to remotely control another computer. Okay, if you have to take to remotely control another computer by using this virtual network computing. So, it transmits the keyboard and mouse events from one computer to another. So, it may be relaying the graphical screen updates back in the other direction throughout over a network. This is the concept of virtual network computing. Now, we can see the application support for multi-user multi-account interaction. Which application we want to use for multi-user multi-account interaction? What exactly I want to say in the sense, our extensions to the application platform. Okay, our extensions to the application platform described above, we want to enable applications to link users to actions. This in turn allows all users for acting on their on behalf of the support for multi-user multi-account interaction. We describe how the project talk makes use of this functionality here. What does exactly in the sense, what I mean to say now, our extensions to the application platform, in the sense application platform as a service, it refers to the cloud environment for designing and building as well as deploying, and we want to managing the custom business applications. So in simply terms, it's a single platform that enables speed and collaboration, and we want to control across the entire application life cycle. So what we want to describe above, to enable the applications, the act of putting to a special purpose to link users to actions. Okay, this in turn allows all users for acting on their on behalf. We describe how the project talk, in the sense project talk, in the sense to devise in the mind, to design in the mind what we want to plan, that figure what we want to estimate for the future, that project, how the cost, the to cast forward, trust the project, how we want to talk, in the sense to help someone, it should be understand, or to do something by explaining it in the way of steps, in a careful way. The woman on the phone talked me
through the procedure. It is nothing but a talk to help someone to understand what I am saying exactly. It makes use of this functionality here. This is nothing but the concept of application support for multi-user, multi-account interaction. This is the overall concept, ma. Okay, this is the concept of multi-user, multi-account interaction. One more concept if we have to learn there, that is nothing but impersonating hands. In the sense, until now, multiple local or remote users can interact with the applications simultaneously and independently because users have their own hands. However, there is no relation between the user and a cursor on the screen. That is, the application does not have any information about the sorts of events. So, to provide this link between users and their hand, we suggest to impersonate hands. If you want to take the hand objects, what we want to describe in the sense, the trigger, small device, the application processing of user interface framework events. Okay, according to that, the suggested concept, hand objects have to manage the user credentials. Okay, and this is the concept of multi-user, multi-account interaction by using impersonating hands. How the next section describes how an application can use this information to link application actions to user accounts. So when a user logs out, the user credentials are removed from that hand. This is the concept related to the impersonating hands. Okay, later we discuss the further topic, that is nothing but importance of communication in design thinking, in further video. Thank you, ma. Up to now.